Hello, baby.
This is Sam Franklin. I used to be married to him.
Anna, you're pregnant. Let me help.
What?
I was after the manager of this place.
You're looking at her.
Where is the sweepstake? I want to make a bet.
I found you the sweepstake.
You can get off me now.
Don't you get that you just being here is confusing the hell out of me?
Last night I made some calls to Tokyo, and I'm pleased to inform you, I'm now the proud owner of Hotel Babylon.
A week ago, I was in charge of a range of global businesses, living the dream. Now I'm waiting to find out what's left of it. The one asset I know I still own is Hotel Babylon. But what do I know about hotels, I hear you ask? Well, I've stayed in plenty, and with a CV like mine, running a hotel should be a walk in the park. I've been handling people all my life. I know how to make them happy.
When the owner guaranteed you tickets, he failed to appreciate the popularity of the show.
Or the lateness of the hour.
What is it?
The slug.
It's also a classic con.
You eat 95% of your meal, then you put a grub on the plate and complain.
No, Sam fell for it.
He gave them vouchers for a free dinner.
Morning. Did you get the ticket?
No.
Great. Thank you. Morning.
No one could say that Sam Franklin never let them down.
Sam.
I've got to take a shower. I'll be right back down.
As owner, your job's simple. Make sure everyone feels valued and appreciated.
Sam, I need you to sign off some ideas I've had on improving the profile of hospitality area.
Sorry, now's not a good time. Michael.
I tidy your room special, so now it is...
Yeah, just give me a sec, Tanya.
Yep.
Clean.
Give it to me straight. What have I got left?
Hotel Babylon is definitely all I have. I'll call you later.
And if life throws you a curveball, your job is to pick yourself up, smile, and get on with it. You roll with the punches, and you fight back.
I make effort.
Head of housekeeping?
Mr. Sam promote me.
Wow, queen of the cleaners. Hi. Well, you'll be pleased to know you missed my happy to be general manager speech, but the key points were that I welcome gratuitous chocolate gifts and I love a good party.
Me too. Oh, we're so going to get on.
Now, on the off chance that you may tire of another 10-minute monologue from me, I'd like to open it to the floor. So what have we got this weekend?
Well, as I'm sure you're all aware, we have Ed and Erin Martin staying with us.
Oh, great.
Yeah, how could we forget when that's all you talk about?
Well, I would suggest that the lifestyle gurus and television celebrities are our premier guests. Chef and I have already looked over their own recipe books and come up with some additional ideas for their joint birthday dinner.
All this stuff's wholesome family food, isn't it? What are you going to do, wild bean casserole and brown bread and butter pudding?
James, run this event like a military exercise. Gino, I want a bit of this. Gino, I want a bit of that. Gino, I want a bit of the other. And everything in the restaurant has to close at 5:05, because Mr. Slickpants here, he wants to watch the Ed and Erin show. What good have they ever done anyone, eh?
What, they've changed the way that civilians live their lives, that's all.
Absolutely, bringing back good old-fashioned values, home cooking and family meals.
I think they're evil, actually. Well, they set themselves up as the perfect family and make everyone else feel inadequate.
We've also got the European heavyweight challenger staying, Fernando Gomez.
Now you're talking about somebody who changed lives, eh?
I thought he just rearranged faces.
Yeah, he's going to rearrange your British challenger's face, that's for sure. Spain going to smash Great Britain, eh?
Boxing in gloves is for women. Real men fight with bare fists and teeth.
I think that two men thumping each other for entertainment is just repulsive.
Yeah, well, you don't need to worry about that. There's not going to be much thumping. Just a quick bang, bang from Gomez and your boy Morrison on his back.
Last time out, Morrison destroyed Helmut Schneider. And Gomez has yet to face a southpaw. What? You think I shouldn't know about boxing because I'm a woman?
Yes.
Morning.
Sorry, this is a staff meeting.
Yeah.
And you're here because...
Looking good, Tanya.
My first contribution is an initiative from City Hall. Leading up to the 2012 Olympics, they're seeing how eco-friendly hospitality businesses are, checking their carbon footprints, etc.
Oh, we already have pretty good green credentials. Well, I, for one, always recycle my makeup containers.
Another small country saved.
It's called the Green Pillow Scheme, and I've arranged for someone from their office to do an on-site inspection. Today.
Today?
Well, as Emily says, we've already got great credentials. He or she will just turn up, take the relevant boxes, award us top marks. Anyone fancy taking it on?
Oh, me.
No, thanks. It's all media hype whipping up hysteria.
I think it's a key issue, actually.
Passion. That's what I like to hear. Thank you, Emily. Inspector will turn up sometime this morning. Oh. Okay, that's it.
People don't come to a five-star hotel to wonder whether we're recycling their shampoo bottles or using eco-friendly mouthwash.
So I take it you're not a jolly green giant then, James?
Not jolly green anything at the moment.
It's a bandwagon.
I need to book four rooms for a friend of mine this weekend. Superior rooms.
We'll fully booked.
Well, you just do the Rubik's Shuffle. You just twist, move and rearrange. You bring two guests up from the third floor to the sixth floor and two down from the sixth to the fourth. Then that frees up rooms on the fifth and third floor. So what you do is you move one person from the first floor up to the sixth floor, one down from the sixth to the third floor. Then that frees up rooms on the fourth, fifth and third floor, which means if you fill them with people from the seventh floor, you've got four superior rooms available.
What she said? The guest name's Foreman. Carlton Foreman. Is it coming?
No. They are.
Mr. and Mrs. Martin, I'm Juliet Miller, the general manager.
Hello. How do you do?
Welcome to Hotel Babylon. We're delighted to have you staying with us.
And we're delighted to be here, aren't we?
Well, if you'd like to take a seat, we'll bring you over a complimentary drink while we check you in.
Actually, I'd love to see where the party's going to be. You want to stay home and get a drink, darling?
I want to stay with you.
Oh, 12 years of marriage and she still can't get enough of me.
Oh, stop.
Well, we already have your payment details, so here are your key cards, Mr. and Mrs. Martin.
Annie, do you want to take Tyler up to the room? We'll be up in a bit.
Can I just say what a massive fan I am? The item you did last week about the mind-blowing holiday disasters. It was mind-blowing. The herd of cows, tip-top caravan.
Yes. When are you due?
Oh, about a month.
Ed loved it when I was pregnant.
Well, there's nothing more amazing than a pregnant woman.
Yeah, you should try it from this side.
Oh, if he could have had Tyler himself, he would have.
Well, the scans, the checkups, the prenatal classes, I can get enough. I hope your fella's pulling his weight.
Yeah, he is.
Mr. and Mrs. Martin, shall we?
Great.
Bye.
Bye, I think.
I feel like I've just met royalty.
I think I'm going to be sick.
What?
So, everyone could go over this list and be ready to answer any questions the inspector may have.
So, I've been back to school.
How would you know?
Come on. Who's that Anna baby father front runner?
Right, no front runners, but about 700 of us. Anna, could you...
Maybe I should just ask for the weekend door.
What's up?
She's had a first brush with the country's most famous family.
Oh, and they made you feel rubbish, didn't they?
Well, they noticed the bump, asked her about the dad, and then she threw up.
Welcome to parenthood, where most of the time you feel ill-equipped and inadequate, and the rest of the time you feel nauseous.
Talking of parenthood, none of you saw Anna's baby scan pictures.
Oh,
can we see?
Yeah.
Okay, now... Looks like it's got James' nose, but that's impossible.
What about the chin?
The head shape reminds me of...
No, the guy. Do you remember the guy with the dark hair?
No.
Which one?
Who?
What's his name?
I thought that you stopped taking bets.
Well, we did. We had.
But we start again.
I thought you were genuinely interested in the baby, but you know, you just want to win some stupid bet. Well, from now on, just don't even look at me.
Anna, it's just a bit of fun.
No, it's not.
Oh, come on, Anna, just give us some clues.
Is the father tall?
Is he dark hair?
Is he black?
Is he at least someone that we all know?
Put us out of our misery.
Okay, fine. All right, you really want to know who the father is?
Yes.
Well, you really, really just want me to tell you?
Yes.
Well, you just want me to come out and say who the father is?
Yes.
Okay, fine. It's him. All right. Wish me right in the money.
So I take it darkness and alcohol play their part in your coupling with Darren, the waiter.
Why? Is he not good looking?
I mean, he's okay, but ordinary looks coupled with no money measure somewhere between the Elephant Man and Quasimodo on your scale.
Hey, you. We have rooms, yes?
Looks or not, you've got them.
Fernando, ustedes verdadero el campeón del pueblo. Ustedes el corazón y alma de España. Hombre.
Come on, man.
Hey, I'm a biggest fan. I just want to shake your hand.
Mr. Gomez, I'm Juliet Miller, the general manager. Welcome to Hotel Babylon.
Hello.
I'm so sorry about the fan, and I guarantee he won't pester you again, but he is actually our bar manager, so we may need him.
Rafael, Gabriel, the file, really. It's bar manager key. Okay.
Fernando, still your biggest fan, eh?
Hello, reception. Anna Thornton-Wilton speaking.
Oh, another one's gone.
So, who is this?
She's gone.
So have you had au pairs walk out on you before?
Both times.
I know that looking after someone else's kid is a pretty thankless job, but it's hardly rocket science, is it? I mean, what do you want for breakfast? What do you want for lunch? You can go to the park. Here's your dinner. Calm down. Get to bed! It's easy. You're funny. Funny ha-ha, funny weird.
Weird, definitely.
Okay, let's get you back to your mummy and daddy now.
And I'm 11, not 2.
Yeah, whatever.
No. Let me phone our office and check out the hopsack weave linen we featured in our last book. I think it's going to give the room a much more homely feel.
Well, you're the expert on homely.
The chef thought the risotto al funghi would be a more appropriate accompaniment to the lighter antipasti choices.
Oh, all sounds good, James. I know nothing about wine, never touched the stuff, so I'm leaving the choices to your Spanish sommelier.
Our who? Oh, our barman. I've called him many things, but a sommelier? No.
Hey, small fry, what's been happening?
Your nanny's walked out on you.
What?
Yep, Tyler just rang down to reception and I saw her walking out of the main door.
Oh, no. What are we going to do about it?
Well, we'll just have to keep Tyler with us for the weekend.
What, while we put a television programme together, while we talk to scriptwriters and producers? He'll be bored, Ed. Jesus, I'm bored talking to them and I'm an adult.
Darling, we'll sort something.
So what are we going to do? We've got all our friends coming to a party, you know? No, we're just going to have to cancel. Just tell them it's all off.
No, we're not going to cancel.
Maybe we could help. Well, I could ask a member of staff to look after Tyler while you're here, give you time to sort something else out long term.
So do you have, like, a child-minding thing here?
No, but how about Anna? Yes, well, you've forged a relationship with Tyler, haven't you?
No, not really.
And you could do with the practice?
Yeah.
And it would be much less taxing for you than standing up for 8-hour shifts.
I can leave.
Tyler? Tyler, what do you think?
Yeah, Tyler. Do you want a bossy, weird woman looking after you?
Why not?
That's sorted then. Thanks. Now, this risotto. Mm. I don't like risotto. I think we should have fish.
Tough life being an owner.
I'm sorry.
Did I miss the memo about the Neanderthal lookalike competition here today?
There's no ordinary Neanderthal.
Let's dump it with Morrison and his entourage.
Full security. I want this reprobate out of here now.
Oh, shut up. This man is posing as a hotel manager and run a bloody bath. Bloody charlatan.
You don't call, you don't text.
Why the hell would I call you? Good to see you, Sammy. Listen, thanks for sorting out the rooms.
Oh, what a mate's fault. Anyway, so last I heard you were in Arizona mining uranium?
Arkansas, actually, digging for copper. I didn't find any. So I fell into the boxing game.
Boxing?
Yeah. And this is my latest charge, Don Morrison, European heavyweight champion.
What are you looking at?
Just you, you're not so big, close up.
You Spanish?
Si.
I hate the Spanish.
Why don't you just shake hands and play nice?
I didn't know the Spanish was so strong. Call up the fight, Carlton.
Nuts. So I'll go get him checked in.
Gonna have a word for you, Sam. So we've got a big problem. And you need to sort something out before Juliet.
Is that who I think it is? Who booked him in?
What's the problem?
You arrive late tomorrow, don't you? So you have no idea that we also have Fernando Gomez booked in this weekend.
Fernando who?
You don't follow sport, then?
Not really.
No.
Fernando Gomez is Morrison's opponent in the big fight this weekend.
We've got both boxers staying here.
Fantastic.
Sam, you're not getting it. They can't both be here. Morrison has to go.
Jules? Jules? Hello?
Carlton? What are you doing here?
It was Carlton who phoned me for the rooms. He's actually Morrison's manager.
Look, if you're staying here as well, we should definitely all get together and have a meal. Talk about old times.
I work here, actually.
What? You work... with Sam? No!
Oh, no!
What's so funny?
No offence, but the best thing you two ever did was get away from each other. Now you're working together.
Yeah, and it's going pretty well.
Good. Well, I just hope I'm not around when it all goes tits up again.
Funny you should mention, actually, you not being around.
Why don't you get yourself checked into the room and we'll have a catch-up drink later.
Carlton and Morrison cannot stay here.
Why not?
Because at this stage of a fight, boxers are programmed to kill their opponent on sight. If either party finds out the other one's staying here, they'll murder each other. He has to go.
I can't throw him out. I owe him.
What? Money?
When we split up, I was in a mess. He was there for me.
So he broke out the whiskey and tissues, and now you're honour-bound to help him out?
Why do you dislike him so much?
It might be something to do with his mentioning every one of your past conquests in his best man speech, or the fact that your golf weekend's away lasted till Tuesday.
I can't throw him out.
I thought we agreed that I was going to run this hotel.
Okay. Cards on the table? I spoke to Michael this morning. Hotel Babylon's all I have left. Everything else is gone.
Everything?
which means I'm staying put. But together, we can make a real go of this place. Make some serious money. What do you say?
This is not what we agreed to, Sam.
The answer I'm looking for is yes.
And the answer you're getting is maybe.
I can work with maybe.
You need to issue the timetables for both the boxing camps.
Any deviations from the itineraries by either party, and you need to contact me, Sam, or Tony ASAP.
You know the score. These two groups must never meet. Understand? Never.
Muchas gracias, Newby. De nada.
Gracias.
Let me wish you luck, eh?
Sí.
Beat this pitbull man, eh?
Yeah.
Hey, kill him if you have to.
Yeah.
Do it for Spain.
It's okay. Okay.
Mr. Well, thank you very much, gentlemen.
Thanks.
Right, do something.
Mr. Morrison, if I could break with protocol for 1 minute and ask you to sign this napkin for me.
We'll take you for a fight, fam.
I love a good scrap, me. If you could write to James, love from, or just from would be fine.
You don't have a bicycle stand?
This is a five-star hotel.
So?
So couriers go around the back.
There's nowhere to put my bike.
Don't tempt me, mate.
I'll just have to take it in with me then.
At the risk of stating the bleeding obvious, on your bike.
I am Robert Carrick, environmental officer from City Hall. I believe I'm expected. Congratulations. You've just failed test number one.
Mr. Carrick, welcome to Hotel Babylon. I'm Emily James, head of PR. We are delighted to have you with us today.
I did ask for somewhere to store my bicycle.
Oh, that's easy. Tony, bike.
Course.
I imagine you're a man who likes to hit the ground running. So, I've set up the most energy-efficient route around the hotel, taking in all the key areas. Bedroom. So, I thought I'd take him to the Trocadero Centre and then get him a burger or something for lunch.
No. No, no, no. He can't leave the hotel without us. We also advocate a strictly organic diet, no processed foods. I think he's lactose intolerant. Ed thinks that I'm being too fussy, but...
Fussy wasn't the word I used, sweetness.
So I recommend a limited amount of dairy-based foodstuffs, chocolate being an absolute no-no until after four, where he's allowed two squares max. And we all know that fizzy drinks are the quickest way to tooth decay. And crisps are poison. Now, before I forget, I need you to sign this. It's just a straightforward confidentiality agreement.
Oh, I don't know.
No, it's routine. All our staff sign one.
Well, it's just I think it might conflict with the contract that I have with the hotel.
Just when I thought it was going to work.
Darling, what?
I'm sorry.
I couldn't think of putting him in the hands of a stranger.
You could do it without the agreement.
It's impossible. Just call that manager woman, tell her to cancel the party.
Darling.
Okay, I'll sign.
Thanks.
It's all yours.
How much do pirates pay for their earrings? A buccaneer!
Okay, come on. Hit me as hard as you like, eh? Gino, fear nothing, eh? I wasn't ready.
Why am I always the last to hear?
I'll talk to Chef.
Thanks. Sorry.
Hello. I'm Anna.
Oh, no. Darren.
Was James okay? I just saw him talking to you.
Oh, yeah, he's in a bad mood about the boxes. They want protein drinks, raw eggs and raw liver. He never likes it when people mess with the food.
Right. Okay, listen, you might find some of the staff have been a little bit weird with you today. That's because of me. It's a funny story, but they were pestering me to tell them who the father of my baby is, and I told them it's you. But it's just ridiculous, I know, because as if I would... with you, that would... No. Anyway, if anyone asks, just say that yes, you are the dad, okay?
Cool.
Excuse me, tell a joke.
I don't know if
you... Who are you? Oh, strong. Oh, thank you. Oh, bye, I love you.
Anna, sorry about the sweepstake thing. That was pretty tactless.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, but you're okay.
Yeah, I'm okay.
You know, I'm having trouble understanding how you, of all people, got yourself into this situation.
Yes, I do too sometimes.
So obviously he's the one.
Yeah, I thought he was.
Darren's a nice guy.
Yes, Darren. Yes, no, he's lovely. Oh, lovely Darren.
Yep.
Did she say anything? And is he the dad?
Well, she didn't say that he's not.
The refrigeration system could do with an overhaul to lower emissions.
Oh, I've already booked an engineer to come and have a look at all the machinery.
Have you?
Yes, well, the ventilation's inadequate. The insulation is patchy, and the lighting is uneconomical. You see, we take green issues very seriously at Hotel Babylon, and I am determined to make improvements as and when I feel they're necessary. Shall we?
Looks like somebody's off your job.
You did make sure there wasn't a small boy here before we sat down, didn't you? It's a small boy, very big hair. Bloody hell do you think you're doing?
Playing PSP. And you shouldn't swear.
I was worried sick.
You weren't worried when he dumped me in the lobby.
Do you think it's funny just running off like that?
I didn't run. I walked.
What would your parents say if they knew I lost you?
So it's my parents you're worried about, not me.
Yes, of course, they're famous.
You're rubbish with kids, aren't you?
And you're rubbish with adults.
That's because adults are rubbish.
You know what everyone is. Get used to it. I have to. Do you want this back?
I'm not going to agree, Aaron.
I'm his mother!
I'm his bloody dad! So what?
What's going on?
They're arguing about the divorce again.
The divorce?
I can look after him just as well as you.
Oh, what? Like you did when I was in Barcelona?
You are such a cow.
Are they always like this?
Most times.
Well, you just have to listen.
I didn't want to still be debating this at our bloody party, Ed.
Then agree to 50-50 custody and we can go down and give all our friends the full Happy Martins experience.
70-30, that's my final offer. Just agree to it.
What, so you can squeeze me out?
You are so paranoid.
And you're a scheming cow.
Well, it wasn't me who had the first affairs, sweetheart.
And it wasn't me who had the slushing last.
Hello. Just thought I'd let you know that we're back. And I'm just going to go. So you guys just... And I'll see you tomorrow.
Just a second. This might be a good moment to remind you that you have actually signed a confidentiality agreement.
Yes, she knows that.
Yeah?
I know that.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you such a cow?
I haven't been married for you for 12 years.
God, I hate you!
Would you like me to take you somewhere else?
It's okay, I'm used to it.
I'm sorry for being horrible to you today.
You're just being yourself, right?
Yeah. There are notices in every bathroom telling guests to reuse their towels.
And we all know that's less about saving the planet and more about saving your laundry bills. The cleaning products you have are chock full of petrochemicals and phosphates, and the soap crammed with unbiodegradable oils and lards.
So what do I do?
I'd suggest a very large bonfire.
Is Morrison White back from the Ivy?
And where's Gomez?
So he's up in his room.
So go green.
Oh, no.
What the hell are you doing here?
I stay here. What are you doing here?
I'm here to put your lights out, Mr. Gomez.
I'm here to castrate the people. Cabron.
Do something.
What? All right, gentlemen. Let's keep our lid on it, nice and friendly. You know, save it for the rain, eh? Hey?
Yes,
we need to contain this. We need to keep it out of the press.
Okay, I'll go and find Emily.
What happens if it's broken?
Then the fight gets cancelled, a lot of people lose a shitload of money, and I hate to say this, but this hotel is then up the proverbial creek without a paddle.
Come on, come.
Come on what, Sam? Seriously, what do you want me to do? You booked both boxes into the same hotel.
This didn't hurt so much, I'd deal with you myself.
I didn't know Gomez was staying here till after you'd arrived.
And then when you did know, what, you couldn't tell us then?
I didn't want you to feel like you had to leave.
You're a moron.
Seriously, mate, I'd rather have been given the choice and have left, because frankly, with the personal sponsorship, the television and advertising revenue loan, we stand to lose several million pounds, all of which I'm going to try and recoup. So, I'm going to have to sue this hotel.
Look, I know I messed up, but this could ruin me.
So, mate, this is business, yeah? Pure and simple. Anyway, first things first. I need a private clinic, get Don's hand x-ray, then we'll see what we're up against.
I'll arrange it.
Oh, hey, big lady.
Big lady.
The old me have awakened the beast inside. No, you are not a big lady. You are a tiny little rose with a little baby inside.
It doesn't matter. I'm just in a bad mood.
Here.
What's this?
This is the Mexican AA.
The Mexican AA?
Si. No alcohol, but spicy flavor.
Okay.
Oh, you lost your cherry. Here.
So what happened?
Oh, the scars of war. Lucky for Tony that Gino was there to help him out. Come on, tell Gino. You have a baby on the way. Why are you not blooming like a big ripe tomato?
It just hit me that I'm having a baby. I knew that I was having a baby, but I just realised that I'm, like, actually having a baby. Like, I'm going to have a baby. I don't have anything ready. I don't have a nursery. I haven't got any nappies. I went out to buy a cot the other day, and I came back with new shoes. How are new shoes, even gorgeous ones? They're, like, velvet, and they've got, like, Diamante heels. How are they going to help my baby? What sort of a well-dressed mother does that make me?
Look, nobody is cool with kids until they actually have kids. I have a son, you know.
Yeah, I know, little Gino.
Oh, no, this is another one, in Barcelona. He's 12, Cristiano.
Oh, do they not have sex education in Spain?
Oh, yes. I was a young waiter in a hotel, 29, charming, handsome, virile, a ladies' man, you know?
No, I can't picture that.
Well, Marta pictured it. She was the waitress, and we did the naked mambo underneath a bloody red moon.
God.
But I get the wonder lost again. I move off to pastures new. I didn't know about him until 4 years ago, when my sister got absolutely bladdered at the party and blurted out.
So what did you do when you found out?
What could I do, eh? She has robbed me the chance of being his father.
Is that how you feel, that you robbed?
Every child needs his father. And every father needs his child. A man has a right to know the truth, eh? But you're okay. You have your father. You have Darren. He'd be very good for bringing sandwiches. A waiter. Very useful.
As you can see, we already have an extensive recycling system in place, so shall we move on?
Wait! This was in with the brown glass. Looks like I'm going to have to dig a lot deeper. I hope you've got rubber gloves.
She like, eh?
Who?
Anna. I bet she like a dark-haired Venus, eh?
Yeah.
Like a tigress, eh?
Yeah, it was electric.
And no hanky-panky. Otherwise, you'll have Gino to answer to, eh? Okay?
Right.
Go.
Sam, I need to speak to you urgently about the green pillow man.
What's he still doing here?
Well, as the day's gone on, he's got harder and harder to please.
What do you want me to do about it?
Well, talk to him. And it will help. The restaurant.
Oh, joy.
Red snapper. Where's that from? The Gulf of Mexico, I believe.
There's also some great British produce, right, James?
The old cheese, I suppose. Australian barramundi. New Zealand lamb. Oh, I see you're offering mangosteen from Thailand.
It's an extensive menu of fine dining.
An extensive global menu that's clocking up the air miles and CO2 emissions.
I think you'll find we're no more profligate than any other Michelin-starred restaurant, Mr. Carrick.
Which is no excuse for complacency. I'm going to be here for some considerable time.
I suppose I should find somewhere nearby to stay overnight.
Why don't we organise a room for you here?
I don't think so.
We're eager to facilitate this process in any way we can.
Well?
Have the room for as long as you like. Emily, if you'd like to get Mr. Carrick checked in.
Yes, this way please, Mr. Carrick.
Checking up on me?
I just came to apologise. It was a crappy thing I did, and I'm sorry.
It's all right. I quite enjoyed people thinking I was the dad. Felt good.
Well, I'm going to tell everyone you're not, and let you off the hook.
You don't have to. I mean, I've been playing along. It's cool.
Really? All right. Well, just don't get any weird ideas, okay?
Okay, darling. Too much, right?
Way too much.
Yeah.
About the brawl in reception. Somebody said that you were, what was it? Slapping like a girl?
Look, have you know, when I was a young man, I was a boxer,
and punched in the head repeatedly as a youth. Explains a lot. Emily, what room is that inspector in?
301, why?
Also.
Room service. Lobster, green-lipped mussels.
Mozambique lobster, Norwegian mussels, and a very fine French champagne.
You look closely, the cracks always start to show.
I am going to have him monitored overnight.
But everyone's got secrets.
Right.
You must have some dirt to dish on them.
I can't tell you.
But you tell me everything.
Hang on.
What's that?
Well, they made me sign a confidentiality agreement, so if I do one with you, then I can tell you anything, right?
Bring it on.
Now spill the beans.
The Martins are getting a divorce.
No!
Yeah.
No! Can I help you, man?
I'm sure you could. Unfortunately, I'm here to meet a friend.
If you ask at the front desk, I'm sure they will help you find it.
Thanks.
What's the world record for owning and then losing a hotel?
Whatever it is, I'm sure you're in the running.
Given half the chance, I think I could have made a pretty good fist of this place.
Come on, Sam, you've been down before.
Yeah, I've usually had some assets tucked away somewhere before. But this time...
You've always loved a challenge.
Carlton says that's why I married you.
And Carlton's a real expert in relationships, isn't he?
You've really got it in for him, haven't you?
He made a pass at me when we were married.
When?
You were in Scandinavia trying to get that bottled water business off the ground. And he called round and took me out. I think he thought as he'd forked out for dinner that I owed him something. And on that happy note, I'm going to get some sleep.
You don't fancy another?
No. I'll see you tomorrow. For the duration of the party.
Oh, you'd like that, wouldn't you? Sweep it all under the carpet.
We're never going to agree about custody, are we?
Well, not until you start trying to screw me over, no.
Please, don't use the word screw in relation to you and I. It makes me feel unwell.
I mean, you're trying to reduce the amount of time I get to spend with Tyler, which I will not stand for, you poisonous...
Hey, Matt. Jody, glad you've
made it. Catch up in a bit. I will never back down over this.
That's why I made a decision last week.
Yeah, about what?
I've had an offer from the US to set up a media branch of our business there.
You've what?
Though my lawyers first thing this morning told me it was a go. Hi, glad you could
be here. Sergio. Come by. Tutto a posto. Great to see you.
Tyler and I will be splitting our time between here and the States.
You've been planning this all along, haven't you? You selfish, conniving bitch.
Oh, I'm so glad.
The hand is definitely fractured.
Afraid so. So I'm going to have to instruct my lawyers and start legal proceedings against the hotel.
Don't do this.
I don't have a choice.
Carlton, we've been friends for years.
Listen, Sam, there is no way I can absorb these costs myself, okay? And the bottom line is, you messed up. All right, look, the only possible alternative I can think of is if we come to some agreement.
Settle out of court.
Did you have a figure in mind?
Well, obviously it's got to be a figure I'm happy with.
Of course it has.
Hey, Jules, I'm reaching out here.
You're all hot.
Don't forget, I'm the wronged bloody party.
Well, tell me something I don't know.
Okay, can I make a suggestion? Can I suggest you piss off and let Sam and I deal with this ourselves?
Did you just tell Juliet to piss off?
Yes, I did. Sound advice.
Why don't I make a suggestion? If you're going to sue me, then let's do it through the proper channels.
Sam, you are making a huge mistake.
No, I made a huge mistake thinking you were someone I could trust. It's only fair that I keep you all in the loop. We may well be taken to court over this, and if we are, it could turn nasty.
I don't remember seeing Morrison throw a punch.
What?
Well, I'm trying to work out when he actually hurt his hand, and I don't remember seeing him throw right.
Look, he must have done.
He's soft, anyway. I shook his hand when he first arrived, and he cried like a baby. Gino is stronger than he know.
Show me how you shook it?
Yes.
Yeah, that's like a limp lettuce.
Hey.
Well, how could that have happened?
He had it caught, but he never actually threw it.
What, you're an expert on boxing all of a sudden?
I had an ex-boyfriend who was a boxer.
You went out with a boxer?
I didn't go into a nunnery after our divorce.
What was he? Middleweight? Light welter?
Does it matter?
No, not to me. No.
Do you think that Morrison hurt his hand before he actually got it?
I think there's a good chance, yeah.
Come. Just the man we wanted to see.
Notified your lawyers, yeah?
We thought we'd give you a chance to explain yourself first.
Explain myself? Is this your pathetic attempt to try and wheedle out of being sued?
No, it's our way of saying we know what you did. When did you injure your hand, Don? It wasn't last night, was it?
Seriously, you are wasting your time.
Something to hide, Carlton.
You knew that Gomez was staying here before you came, didn't you? What did Carlton tell you? What did he offer you to carry out the con?
All right, look, I want you out of my room now.
It's not your room, it's mine.
Not for much longer, mate. Things go my way.
I understand why a devious slug like Carlton would do this, but you don't strike me as a dishonest person.
I'm not.
You're a champion, a great sportsman. You believe in fair play.
Oh, please. Don? Think about this very carefully. Remember what's at stake.
Carlton's priorities lie solely with himself. When did you injure your hand? Honestly.
A month ago.
I'll call Jake Samuels, see where we stand legally on this. Juliet, it's started. I've already been fielding calls from the press about a brawl in a hotel.
Right, then organise a press conference for Don Morrison and use that to appease the journalists for the time being.
Okay.
Emily, sorry, did you have a chance to tell Sam about our Eco Warriors room service over?
Yes.
Has anything else happened?
Well, he had told me that he wanted to do a random inspection today.
Which is odd, because Tandy says he hasn't taken the Do Not Disturb sign off his door.
Well then, we should disturb him. Mr. Carrick?
He's used every towel in the hotel.
The air conditioning's on full blast, windows are open.
You're so clever squeezing a whole night out of him.
You have me running round like a blue-assed fly. And for what?
I really am sorry, but you should see some of the dumps I usually have to inspect. I just thought, one night of luxury to compensate for the other 300-odd spent in lumpy beds with migraine-inducing wallpaper.
So, what are you going to rate us?
I think I can guarantee you a 4-point rating. No one gets 5.
Now, I'm not going to bore you with a long speech, I'm going to bore you with a short one instead. Thank you. All for coming and sharing this bleakest of moments where Ed and I topple headlong into our 40s. Talking of whom? Thanks, Ed, for 12 glorious years of marriage. And you are terrific son, Tyler. I love you both very, very much. Now, as you all know, Ed's a bit of a nerd. A poetry nerd. So I asked him to write us a bit of a poem for our birthday, and in a moment of utter madness, and with the promise of various sexual favours, he agreed. So before he becomes too incapable, over to you, darling. Darling.
Yes, darling. Thank you, darling. The end of love should be a big event. It should involve the hiring of a hall. Why the hell not? It happens to us all. Why should it pass without acknowledgement? Suits should be dry cleaned, invitations sent. Whatever form it takes, a tiff, a brawl, the end of love should be a big event. It should involve the hiring of a hall. Better than the unquestioning descent into the trap of silence, than the crawl from visible to hidden, from door to wall. Thank you. As you probably gather, that's not one of mine. It's by Sophie Hannah. A little more appropriate, though.
Let's give him a great big round of applause. He likes those.
Stay there.
You're missing the party.
Good. I hate parties. Where's Erin?
She's downstairs still.
Pouring oil on troubled waters. That's my girl.
Why don't you go back downstairs too?
Stay there.
You could just save the full-blown breakdown for tomorrow morning.
She's toying with me. I don't stand a chance of getting custody. Because between her and her hotshot lawyers, she'll freeze me out.
So how's being drunk and abusive going to help your cause? Be careful, this is a second floor, for God's sake.
What, between the devil and the deep blue sea? I'm just testing you.
How many of those have you got?
What's wrong with him?
He's just a little bit tired and emotional, that's all. Right, Ed?
Tired is right. Sick and bloody tired.
Mum, Tyler!
Oh, right on cue!
You selfish son, I'm gonna kill him.
You stay in there, you!
What the hell are you doing? What was all that about downstairs? Have you any idea how hard it's been convincing people nothing's wrong?
Then don't.
We agreed how we were going to work this.
But it's all bullshit.
Well, this is it, Ed. Yeah, the end.
Please.
Yes, the bitter bloody end.
You're a selfish bastard.
So you're calling me selfish?
Yes, I bloody am.
Right, stop. Just stop it now. All I've heard from both of you is how bad you're feeling and what you want. But there is another person caught in the middle of this, and if you stop for 1 second to think what he wants or how he's feeling... Because I've been with Tyler less than 12 hours, and I can see that this is making him miserable. It is making you all really miserable.
He doesn't understand what's going on.
Oh, no, yes, he does. He understands exactly what's going on because he has to listen to you every day for months. He understands better than you two idiots. So just talk to him. Find out what he wants before it's too late. And I know the first thing he wants is for you to get off that bloody wall. Get it. Now sit down. Now talk.
I'm sorry.
Welcome, everyone. I think we all agree that it's been an incredibly frustrating and disappointing 24 hours for boxing fans, and for Mr. Morrison in particular. He has a prepared statement that he'd like to read out.
I apologise to Fernando and his team, to my team, and most of all to the fans. I'm a fighter. All I want to do is fight. And I let myself be misled by a bad manager and I'm really sorry.
Thank you very much. Which means we aren't going to America, so I can see Dad when I like.
Well, that's good.
If Dad are happy, they should split up, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Here, you should have this for when it gets too much in reception.
Thank you very much.
Is it a boy or a girl?
Yeah, I've no idea.
Whatever it is, it's lucky.
Why'd you say that?
Because he'll have a good mum.
Do you think so?
If all goes wrong with the dad, I promise you won't stay together just for the kid.
Okay, I promise. You sure you're only 11? Right, so how do we kill zombies?
So maybe we're missing a trick here. I mean, after we release the news of the divorce, we could rebrand, become the Ed Martin and Erin King show, aimed at the newly separated parents.
Looking at how you nurture a single parent, seeing both points of view.
It's good. I'll phone Pete out of a meeting.
Great. Actually, it's very, very good.
I think you may need this a little bit longer.
Hope you enjoyed your stay, Mr. Carrick.
It's been such a pleasure.
Aren't you forgetting something, Mr. Carrick?
Running a hotel is no walk in the park, believe me. It takes dedication, application, and above all, admitting your mistakes.
So you're really keen to gain that certificate?
What's it going
to
do except attract a lot more picky people in organic socks and edible shoes?
Oh, hear, hear.
OK, everyone, let's get back to work. Sorry. I really think this could work, don't you?
Oh. You need to get to meetings on time, run new ideas past me first, be open and straight about any planned changes, and let me run my team.
Does that mean you're going to stay?
For the time being.
Thank you.
There's a long way to go, Sam. Don't thank me yet.
When all's said and done, we need to learn to ask for help if we need it.
I just wanted to say, if you need anyone to be around for you and the baby, someone to get things, go to the shops, buy nappies and stuff.
I'd like a servant.
I suppose.
Thank you.
Thank you for making me the dad.
Tea, milk, no sugar.
Yeah?
What do you think? You're the daddy.
I think I'd put you higher on my hit list. And that's saying something.
So, are you ready to come clean yet?
What?
I mean, we all know that Darren's not the dad.
And as I'm the most trustworthy and reliable person here, and because you're dying to tell somebody, why don't you tell me?
Because it's all very well being strong and self-reliant, but some secrets are impossible to keep.
Okay.
Harold stole 12 cut emeralds, which he claims he hid somewhere in the hotel.
It's a hoax. I mean, you really think there's buried treasure here?
I don't like the look of you. You remind me of Errol Flynn. Bust.
Are you sure you're going
to
be okay?
Got ages to go. Oh, my horse is just broken.
Two men have been killed in the hotel.
I've come home to die.
But there's so much to live for.
Where are you? Oh, you know, I've picked a day for it.
I just need a little bit of time just to get my head around all of this.
And Hotel Babylon is back on BBC HD at the same time next week. Next tonight, music from a muddy field with our crystal clear coverage of the Glastonbury Festival.